Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's been a while since I uploaded, but I'm finally back. So today I am making an updated video on how I take notes, since that's the video that most people voted on. And if you guys want to participate in future polls, don't forget to check out my Instagram. First, I'm going to be showing you guys how my notes look like currently. Right now it is very simple and straightforward, so as long as I get the information down, that's all that really matters. So the notes I'm showing you guys are a set for my French class, so they're mostly based on grammar, vocab, and things like that. Now as for supplies, a pen and a highlighter is more than enough, but if you want to make your notes a little bit fancier and prettier, here are the supplies I personally really like to use. I am a big fan of these Zebra Mildliners, so I do own all of the colors. However, I do know it is a little bit hard to find, so I only use that because I like the color range, so any other highlighter will do the same job. I also like to use a brush pen for my header, as well as a 0.38 Muji pen. All these supplies will be linked in the description, so if you're interested in purchasing any of those, don't forget to check the links below. I am starting my notes by writing the general topic on top of the page using a brush pen. Then, like I said, I like to use a Zebra Mildliner to decorate my header, so I just draw two lines on either side of the title. On the top right hand side of the page, I put down the page number of the notes, and then the left hand, I write down the date in which the notes were taken on. Now onto the actual notes. The way I do this is very simple. I write down the header in just normal handwriting, then I move on to the notes. My notes are done in point form out of convenience, and I only limit to using two symbols. I use a dot to jot down any notes, and then an indented dash to further explain the previous bullet point. So for example, if I want to write "the Spring Day music video was really good," I will write that after a dot, and then any other information to further explain why it's good will be done in an indented dash. Now I'm just showing the same method of note-taking by suggesting my favorite studygrams. For instance, here I wrote "study quill" after a bullet point, and then using indented dash, I said her notes are really pretty and neat. Because I am using this note-taking system for a vocab-heavy class, I will just show you guys how I do my vocabs. It's pretty much the traditional way of doing it. The word is on the left and the definition follows the right. Then this is a little something I like to do in my notes, so if there's anything really important or any additional information that I add in class, I will just draw a box around it so I won't forget when it comes to studying. Now once my notes are done, I like to go back in the same colored highlighter and just highlight the titles, draw the grids for my vocabs, underline any important words or phrases, and just do some little things to make my notes a little bit fancier. And here's just a side-by-side comparison of what I did in this video, as well as how my notes usually look like. So this concludes my How I Take Notes video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. So once again, thank you guys so much for watching. As usual, don't forget to subscribe and check out more of my content, and all of my social medias will be linked in the description box below. I hope you guys found this video helpful, and I'll see you next week.